I think what I would say in a word is that it has been exceptionally good, the change from AON to Minet. And the reason is that Minet is a known brand in Kenya for very many years. It actually was in existence for 43 years before AON came in 1997, which now has been in existence now for another 21 years. But somehow through all those 21 years, the name Minet has stuck, and the market still, even before the rebranding, would refer to us as AON Minet. So it's been a very, it's been a strong, trusted brand over very many years, and the transition has been extremely smooth. The market has taken it very positively because the name Minet does communicate trust. Right. It communicates a rich legacy and history of delivering for the clients.
Right. Now, if the company was doing properly, even in terms of strategy, communication, and the same, what are we seeing in terms of the new offerings to the market that should probably get more participation from the consumers?
Okay. The name Minet now comes with actually a new brand promise. As you know, Minet is now a proudly Pan-African company with great focus on Africa. And the new brand promise, as you can see from our brand literature, is that we are there to secure Africa's future. Right. So that comes with very many dynamics. But the new brand promise also comes with new values that we have. Right. And these values are actually captured in the word heart. Heart in the sense that we have a heart for our clients. And even the name heart as an acronym, it stands for, H stands for honesty, E stands for expertise. And then a brand new thing we've brought on the table is A stands for agility. Right. And then R stands for respect. We are an African setting, and respect is a very big part of our culture. Then T is for teamwork. So, and especially the agility bit of it, in the sense that now decision-making layers have been reduced. And as even as we maintain our global, connection with AON, right, with the global expertise in AON, we are going to be more agile, more responsive to our clients.
Let's talk about cybersecurity, because we know you're keen on this at this particular point. And with this modern age, we need to see a lot more companies focus most of their personnel on the same. How much resource and how much strategy is going into this particular area?
Okay, that's an excellent question, because what we've taken leadership in this particular space on cybersecurity solutions and cybersecurity risk management solutions to organizations and to individuals. And we started this while we were AON, and as at AON, we developed a global and a world leading practice on management of cybersecurity, including provision of cyber insurance solutions. So it is an extremely important practice, and we probably are the ones who have invested most in it, right, and understand it most, and that's why we are actually the thought leaders right now in the market about cybersecurity.
When you say you've invested the most, what are we looking at?
What we are talking about is I'll probably not give you a dollar value, but we are talking about investing in research and development, a lot of R&D in terms of acquisition of talent across the world in understanding this, and also development of insurance market and reinsurance market that can understand this particular product and provide these solutions that are not normally available off the shelf.
Right. Yeah. When we talk about innovation, most of it has been synonymous with banking at this particular point, but we're seeing different companies now take on innovation in the digital space. But we're now being urged not to take digital as a project, but more so as the core of our companies. How has this been? What's the experience?
Actually, you're absolutely right. Right now, we used to say we have a digital strategy, right, but actually, it's actually your company strategy that's in a digital world. So the future is digital. And the future will play out in the digital revolution, and the rate of change is so fast compared to the previous like the industrial age and other ages. The rate of change right now is so fast because of the digital revolution. Right. So everything and all our plans are playing out in the digital space. So and that's why all our strategies, all our plans, around harnessing the digital revolution and the digital transformative resources that are available, right, to be able to deliver better. And the cybersecurity obviously is around is a major component in terms of assisting businesses and individuals play out their strategy and their business plans in the digital era.
Right. In terms of streamlining your workforce to fit maybe the narrative that you have, are we seeing any departments being strangled?
Oh, that's a very important point, in the sense that we are also going through a people transformation agenda, in the sense that now we have about our youth statistics. I think probably about 75% of our people are under the age of 35, for example, if not more. And these are tech savvy employees. So actually, what we are seeing more, it is for us to be able to know how to engage and to harness that potential from our employees more than actually having to exit them because they are not in this space. The beauty with at least Kenya, I would say, is that the majority of the workforce now are actually digital natives.
Right.
So we are not finding a problem having people fitting into the digital era. If anything, it's us knowing how to engage with this, with these young digital natives, to be able to harness their potential to deliver for the clients.
All right. My final point has to do on mega projects across the country and the region. Mega projects are becoming more complex. We're seeing billions of dollars, over 2.5 billion on average, being lost off of this conversation. But how are you ensuring a more deliberate approach to either cushioning yourself when you come to partnering or managing across the border, or execution of deals, partnerships?
Okay. Again, an extremely important question. As you know, right now, Africa's future is actually hinged upon huge infrastructure development. It's hinged upon, a responsible extraction of our mineral resources, and actually also, with a very young population, which is increasing, the fastest increasing in the world, to be able to harness our people and in the digital space.
Right.
Now, all this require very complex and very well thought out risk management and insurance solutions.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what has happened is the key problem that we've been having with regards to this whole agenda is also obviously sometimes corruption. And you've mentioned that there's been a lot of wastage. So what solutions we are bringing out is helping in project financing, especially.
Right.
So we get a seat at the table when the project is being conceived. Then we are able to actually give consulting advice in terms of risk management, where we are able to stop wastage. We are able to stop seepage and leakage,
right,
through proper risk management protocols, right from conception of a project through the financing stage and through to into implementation.
Mm-hmm.
So the buzzword now and the key solution we are providing to Africa to be able to utilize the resources best for infrastructure development in mining and in other areas is actually through risk management.